Tongue paresthesia occurs following damage to the sensory nerve of the tongue, leading to a range of tingling or numbness-related symptoms. These symptoms encompass various sensations, with pain being the most difficult. The individual experience varies depending on pain sensitivity and the severity of the injury.
Hi guys, my name is Diane.
My name is Giovanna.
My name is Natalie.
I am from Recife. I removed my wisdom teeth in 2019.
I am from Presidente Prudente.
I am from Rondonia.
I came here to share with you an experience about wisdom teeth removal.
When I had my wisdom teeth removed, everything was going smoothly during the surgery, including the use of the drill, among other things. But I vividly remember feeling a lot of pressure here for the tooth to come out. I even felt excruciating pain in my jaw.
At first, the dentist was unable to remove the wisdom tooth. We rescheduled the procedure, and during the second time, I felt a lot of pain during the extraction. Then local anesthesia was applied several times.
But then finally the surgery is over, right? And then when I got home a few hours later, I had that strange numb feeling on the left side of my tongue, like it had fallen asleep, right? That didn't stop.
I contacted the dentist. He told me it was normal. The procedure was done at 9 o'clock in the morning when it was in the afternoon. By the end of the afternoon, I still felt my mouth numb.
I was desperate. I had never felt this before.
The sensation I was feeling was very strange. Dry mouth, a burning sensation on the side of the extraction, and I felt that something was not right.
And I called the professional who performed the procedure on me. But he confirmed that the surgery had been smooth, that nothing out of the ordinary had happened, and that it would return with time.
Over time, I stopped looking in the mirror because I realized it was just a sensation. It was only sensory, and that my tongue was actually normal in size.
I researched on the internet about it. In fact, most cases come back over time. And over a few months, I ended up feeling like there was a line inside my tongue and a tingling sensation. I had never felt burning until then. And then I felt like this line was getting shorter.
I told her, and she told me that she had just applied the anesthesia to the nerve. And within a maximum of 30, 60, or 90 days, this sensation would disappear.
And then, when it was a year later, I felt just a small tingling sensation, but nothing that prevented me from living my life, nothing that bothered me. And then 3 years passed. At the end of 2022, I started feeling a burning sensation in that area that I had only felt on the tip of my tongue, just a tingling. And that's when I looked there for some treatments to be able to do.
I underwent treatment with pain doctors, used medications for chronic pain, many medications.
I found on YouTube, well, on the internet in general, treatments that were done with laser therapy, right? That I saw people from cases there who were with... They had done it after 2-3 years, even after the wisdom teeth removal, and they had improved a lot.
I had follow-up with a maxillofacial surgeon. I had follow-up with another dentist. I did physical therapy during this time. I did neural therapy with procaine. I used topical anesthetic. I also underwent transcranial stimulation and needed to have follow-up sessions with a psychologist.
When it completed about 6 months, I received the worst news. I have been to several professionals, and unfortunately, I cannot say they are reliable professionals because they always try to cover up what she had done. Until I went to an experienced dentist who has 40 years of experience in the profession. And he gave me the worst news I could hear, that she cut a nerve and that burning sensation would never go away in my life. that I would have this feeling and this pain for the rest of my life.
And that's when my saga of treatments began, right? I first did 5 laser sessions with a dentist specialized in stomatology and laser therapy. And then I did about 10 laser sessions with another dentist who had more knowledge of laser. I did 10 sessions more associated with pregabalin. And so before doing the laser, I felt this burning sensation in specific crises. And from the moment I started doing the laser, this burning sensation started to become intermittent. After the 5th session, I had crises that fluctuated. And after the 10th session, it became intermittent, 24 hours, nothing passed, no medication. And it was very desperate. Because you imagine you are there trying to treat yourself for a few months and the pain, instead of improving, it ends up getting worse.
I have stayed awake for 7 days due to pain. I couldn't focus on studying. I couldn't engage in any physical activity. I gained 10 kilograms during this time because I developed binge eating disorder. Because it is a sensory nerve, whenever I put something in my mouth or was eating, the pain would decrease slightly, providing temporary relief. So I was mindlessly eating just for the sake of it. Eating was a comforting way to ease the emotional pain. And with that, I gained over 10 kilograms. And there I began to lose the will to live, to do things. Hey, it's a very dark path to walk when you start losing the will to be alive. And that was very present in me. I felt pain every day.
It was very challenging all this time because only...
I went to the dentist and came back like this. So I felt very guilty.
I even doubted if what I was feeling was true, if it was something psychological, because there are doctors who will say that you are feeling that and that it is something psychological, it is burning mouth syndrome, among others.
Because it's not possible. I can't find anyone in the world who has the same problem as mine or who feels the same way I do, because everyone goes to the dentist and goes back to normal, you know? A huge suffering.
And at times, even my family and close friends underestimated the pain. They didn't understand that it was actually something that was bothering my quality of life, impacting my work, my life as a whole. And they even doubted that I found out later, right, that it was all in my head.
At times, some professionals who attended to me even said that I was exaggerating, that it was all in my head, that I would soon get better. And one thing that was very striking to me was that some dentists told me that this would pass, that one day I would go to sleep and wake up and be back to normal. And I waited a long time for that day, but it never happened.
And that's when I started treatment with capsaicin ointment. I did it for 2 months. I did treatment with cannabidiol oil. I did treatment with uvopropic acid. So I went through 7 neurosurgeons. None could help me. No one could identify what the problem was. Everyone said everything was normal. I think the treatments have worsened instead of helping.
And when I realized that it wasn't going to happen, I panicked. I used many medications and often used medications in suboptimal doses. The doctors prescribed me a specific amount of medication, but the pain didn't ease. So I took a slightly higher dose to enable me to sleep and to alleviate the pain somewhat. My friends and family, they all tried to comfort me, but they also didn't know what to say because no one knew anyone who had the same injury as mine.
People didn't understand the depth of my suffering and anguish.
At first, I think even the people who lived with me thought it was an exaggeration. They understood the gravity, so as time passed, right? As time went by and I didn't improve and it didn't go away, the sensation of a numb mouth didn't go away.
After 9 months of suffering, amidst a lot of despair, I had already sought all the professionals in my city and none gave me hope.
But After those treatments failed, I ended up finding a possible solution, which was to find Dr. Thomas.
And then I looked for a friend who specializes in the same field as Thomas, because I had already heard, I had already read about microneurosurgery.
Researching a lot about lingual paresthesia, researching lingual nerve damage, I found Dr. Thomas' content there. And indeed, everything he was saying matched what I was feeling, with the symptoms of intense burning, tingling, discomfort, in short. And that's when I scheduled the appointment with Dr. Thomas. He clarified all doubts. He was super dedicated, super humane. Indeed, he embraced there, welcomed the patient. As many doctors did not welcome me, many doctors in fact prescribed other treatments that if I had followed, I could have even worsened my situation. Treatments that made no sense.
When I opened Instagram, the first post I saw was about Matthias, a patient who underwent this surgery, a patient from Porto Alegre. And he mentioned at the hospital itself that he had undergone the surgery and that this method existed to alleviate our suffering.
And then Dr. Thomas identified that in my case, it was necessary to perform the reconstruction surgery of the lingual nerve there. So we scheduled the surgery.
It was a success. Everything went well. When I woke up from surgery, I no longer had the feeling of suffocation, and I still had a burning sensation, but not throughout the entire length of my tongue.
However, I say that it is also a miracle from God in addition to Dr. Thomas appearing.
I believe it was a sign sent by God, and I had no doubt in my mind to undergo the surgery.
But when he opened up in surgery, my nerve wasn't torn, but it was very compressed. And then he needed to do that decompression, right, to come here and have a certain relief. He has always been very clear that the improvement is not 100%, that some cases improve, others do not improve, but the chances for patients with the symptoms I was feeling are great to improve over time, right? So the only thing I wanted was for the burning sensation to stop, or at least decrease slightly, allowing me to experience a better quality of life in that environment. After the surgery, today I am 25 days postoperative. All my stitches have already fallen out. Your Dr. Thomas is always available to help me. I have already had a follow-up appointment with him.
And I can tell you that if they went through what I went through and are in doubt, do not doubt. God showed this path, keep going, everything will be all right.
I had a level 10 pain, as I mentioned. I tried several treatments and nothing worked. I was going to sleep and wake up. I was desperate, feeling pain. And today I feel a pain at level 3-4. This already counting 25 days just from the surgery.
I was happy as soon as I woke up, realizing that something had already improved. And then we moved on, right? And then I started having some moments where it stopped burning and just became numb the tongue. These moments lasted sometimes a minute, 2 minutes, and it may seem little, but for me it was a lot because I felt pain 24 hours, so I started to be happy with it. Over time, this numbness sensation increased, and I realized that I was improving in the burning sensation, which was what bothered me the most.
As a nerve, it always has its ups and downs. But the surgery was everything I hoped for to alleviate.
The nerve, it tends to improve over the months. The nervous system is a little slower. So Dr. Thomas said that the trend is expected to improve over the next 3 to 6 months.
So when I eat something out of the ordinary, very spicy, very acidic, I feel a certain discomfort. When I get nervous too. So there's really no definitive way to predict how it's going to be. I know that the rest of my life will have limitations, but for sure. The surgery alleviated much more of my suffering.
I can confidently say that I have improved from 80 to 90% of my previous state. I managed to lose weight. I managed to finish college. I was able to start doing things I didn't do before. I started going out again, started doing healthy things.
I am feeling very optimistic. It was a big and important decision for me to have this surgery. I had never had general anesthesia before. I had several fears before the surgery, normal human fear, but both Dr. Thomas and other people I talked to who had this procedure with him calmed me down. And indeed, sometimes we make a big deal out of something in our heads when in practice it is totally different. The surgery was very smooth. I had all the care and support I needed.
So I thank the entire team, Dr. Thomas, Dr. Delson, and the whole team. Nathiele was also very important. She guided me a lot, advised me a lot. So therefore, I just have to thank.
And what would I say to anyone who is suffering this type of injury or is looking for a solution to try to book an appointment with Dr. Thomas? He is the one with the biggest cause in Brazil in relation to the lingual nerve. He has already done several surgeries like this. He also has a lot of knowledge in this type of surgery.
If everyone asked me 1,000 times if I would have surgery again, I would absolutely say yes. I would do it all over again.
And one more thing I would like to say is that there is indeed life after chronic pain. Even though you feel pain every day, even though you have a condition, knowing that you won't go back to what you were before, you can improve, you can recover your life. I needed to rebuild a new life, choose different priorities. I changed even the specialty I once wanted.
And have calm. I know it's desperate at times, and we may find ourselves thinking about things other than our tasks. It's important to stay focused and motivated. We are not welcomed, we feel trapped, but there is a solution regardless of your pain, whether it is at the same level as mine, a little less or a little more. So do not give up on seeking treatment. There is always a solution to make. Living with pain is not normal. It is not all in your head. So do not let people underestimate it. I think that would be the advice I would give to people who are going through this difficult situation with the lingual nerve.